What do Elvis Costello, the Pretenders, Carlene Carter, Reckless Eric, and the Flamin' Groovies all have in common? These seemingly unrelated musicians have all had records produced by Nick Lowe or Dave Edmunds. Until very recently, these two Britishers were fairly unknown to American audiences, faceless names on the back of album jackets. All that changed, however, in 1980 with the resounding success of Lowe's single, Cruel to Be Kind. It turned out that Lowe and Edmunds were one half of a group called Rockpile, a band they had established after years of playing England's pub circuit.
I met Nick through producing an album for a band he used to be in called Brinsley Schwartz, and they broke up, and he was in another band called Fatso, Neil Innes, and they broke up, and Terry was in a band called Men, who were quite popular around here, I believe. And they all seemed to break up at the same time, and it just seemed like there was nothing else to do at the time. And we just got together to do a few gigs in London, and it sort of worked well.
Rockpile was formed right in the middle of Britain's new wave movement, a trend with which they feel very little affinity.
Well, I think the new wave is Blue Moon of Kentucky by Elvis Presley. I think that was the best new wave ever happened.
The members of Rockpile are actually more interested in American roots rock than the newest British wave. In fact, they included a 7-inch collection of their renditions of Everly Brothers tunes with their album Seconds of Pleasure.
Ever since Dave and I first met up, we sung those tunes, you know, in hotel rooms and wherever anyone, you know, wanted to hear them, or we just wanted to hear them, the two of us, you know. And we did the tracks on that EP at a radio station, live, you know, one evening. And when we thought about giving away something with the record, we thought about doing them over and doing them properly, but when we started to record them, it didn't seem any point. They only really sound any good when you can hear all the bum notes and, you know, the forgotten words and things like that. So that's why we put the radio station thing out, which is scrappy to say the least. But it's supposed to be a sort of a tribute, really, as opposed to any kind of recreation.
Here's Rockpile singing Teacher, Teacher.
Out of school, out of love, and out of rules. No one there can tell me how.